Hi legends, today unfortunately I got crypto scammed. It's not fun, it's not exactly what people expect, it's not people that desire that, this is exactly the nightmare of crypto. So it's very hard, it takes a moment to recover. I really try to find a couple of ways to save what is savable. In this case, it were the NFTs, which can have like a very decent value, like the ones in my case. It's not easy to see your money simply flushing away out of a scam. But I at least decided to make a video to try to make it a little bit better for you, so in this way you will be able to maybe avoid this kind of fraud that happened to me, and that's why I want to go in detail and explain exactly how did this happen. Allora, so first thing first, I've been investing in crypto for like 3-4 years, and then the money that got stolen were my first investment, which hurts the most, not only because they were clearly high and higher than what I bought them for, even because it's something that you just don't desire because it's your first investment, it's kind of emotional, and there is everything connected. So to break it down, very simple, I was into one of the tokens that I bought was Elongate. Elongate was created by a dude that just was waiting to create a crypto, and then Elon Musk posted on Twitter when he did not own it already. He just posted a stupid joke or something about Elongate, and this guy created the token with it. Back then, I thought it could have been a quick scalp, essentially a quick swing trading. But yeah, then essentially I kept it, I don't even know why. And now they kind of migrated to the 2.0 version, so it's not just for who bought this crypto, of course this is for everybody, unfortunately. So the way the thing goes, essentially this website was getting flagged by my Windows as this is a phishing website, and in theory I could not move my tokens anymore from the wallet I bought it in, or in which they were in the moment in which this happened, until I finished the migration. So I had to do it. Then it was not really working, and it was not even showing me when I connected my wallet, and then I executed the transaction for which I was simply moving the token to the 2.0. And I just could not stake them, they were not shown there. And then after like 4 days, like an infinite time for crypto, by the way, they just appeared in my wallet. I was using a trust wallet. So the craziness happened because of one single lucky shot from this hacker, or maybe because the website was giving him this information. So the customer support was basically not replying, and I didn't know what to do. I was like, hey, listen, I kind of invested in your token like a couple of years ago now or more, and yeah, where are my tokens? How can I stake them? How can I make them work, you know? And for a moment I was thinking simply to get it, to leave it lost, to keep it a loss, and just decide to just give up and say, oh, listen, I just don't want it. I'll just not do anything with it, and peace, you know, like peace. They went down so much that I really thought it was the case. But then it happened something that was lucky and sad and completely unlucky for other reasons, which is I was reading about this token to figure out whether it was legit or not, because my computer was pointing me that it was a website, and it was the official website that was doing phishing, and it was known for making phishing. So I was like, hey, maybe I shouldn't really do nothing with it, you know, like maybe I shouldn't, I just should forget it, like just, it was just a bad trade, let's just see it like this, like a bad investment. But they had a partnership with Salesforce, you know, the official partner of Formula One, the official partner of a ton of people, and they partnered with Elongate for some sort of news, essentially. And I could not really find it on the Salesforce website. So before making any transaction, before moving anything, I had just an idea, just a wild idea. And the wild idea was to simply ask a Salesforce team. So I simply contacted them and I asked, "Mom, is Elongate in partnership with you? Because it's written in their site, which is a very new kind of blockchain, and it's not written on your site." Unfortunately, they confirmed me that they actually had a partnership with this token. So I just went through and I just wanted to get it done, because at this point, you know, my tokens were simply devaluating. I had to move them. I decided to move them. Okay. So I had to just get it done. Okay. So what I did after, I simply went and I could not find my tokens. I could see them in my wallet after a few days, but I could not see them in the website. And I saw that there was like a guide or something, and it was pointing to many things. I don't know why, I don't know how, but I've been skipping and avoiding like at least 100 scams so far. In this one, I went down the rabbit hole big time, unfortunately. And the main reason was that the guy that was the hacker and the scammer, one actually the best one I've ever seen, unfortunately. What did he do? He contacted me in Twitter, faking that he was the customer support of this website that was definitely made like shit. Made not very well. So when this happened, he contacted me and was, yeah, you know, so try to connect it. I did not work. I was, oh, vabbè, okay. So I mean, how do I resolve it? Because it doesn't make any sense, you know. Should just connect the wallet and it should connect. I tried to make it myself and it did not work. This guy was like, yeah, you know, you just need to either you try to connect your wallet in this website and you get a QR authentication, which sounded very strange to me, but I simply thought that this was a website not very well made, you know, like with alerts all the way through. So I simply imagine that maybe that's the way it was, you know. And then he starts saying a couple of stuff that put me a little bit on alert, but unfortunately it was late, because I connected already the wallet that I had, in which I had stakings up to 7-8 days, so not great, right? And I had a couple of other wallets as well, with some with NFTs, some without, some just with Ether, Polygon, Tron, you name it. So basically he told me, yeah, maybe you just need to keep connecting wallets and just try maybe to connect all of them, because otherwise it doesn't recognize it. And I would have never done it. But then he said another part in this phrase, that maybe simply fall down the rabbit hole. And this was, or you can simply disconnect them and remove them from the device, and just the same. So in there, like, I will show you the chat actually. And what happened was that I simply thought, yeah, okay, but if he's after robbing this wallet, he would not say you can just disconnect them and that's just the same, or something like this. And that's how I got scammed, essentially. Because I entered the wallet and then he tried to tell me, yeah, you need to connect also the exchanges and you can just put passwords there, something like this. And I felt that there was something wrong. And I simply stopped doing anything, And I simply told him to just get it done. Imagine how stupid. Just get it done, man. Just get it done. Seriously. So that's what I did. And he started basically, I told him that I was not connecting my wallet, I connected enough stuff, and if it didn't work, then it should have not. So yeah, then what happened after was bad. because then I start seeing all the transactions out of all the cryptos that I had in the wallets that I connected, which were a ton, frankly. And some I canceled, and some I canceled to simply reinstall them by being so stupid to connect the wallets instead of canceling them from the device, believing in this, you know what. So that's how it went, unfortunately. And now I will show you a little bit more, like in front of the monitor, but hey, this was really not fun. I connected with all the possible customer services. In the next episode, I will tell you how I fixed this problem, how did I get rid of 26 malwares, and how I got my non-fungible tokens back without having to deal with the scammer, because the scammer was also telling me, yeah, if you want to retrieve them, and you just need to go to Telegram, do you have Telegram? And I was like, I do nothing to say now, you know. And yeah, unfortunately it happened to me as well. I covered myself from hundreds of scams. I didn't cover myself from this one, unfortunately. See you next episode.